welcome to this October concert of La Renaissance. We've got something a little different with this program, and those of you who are really into this sort of thing will notice that our groupings don't always make the same sort of chronological sense that a proper music concert sometimes has to make. So we're going to go a little forward, a little backward this afternoon in terms of periods of music. But for the most part, with the exception of the one tune, all of it unaccompanied from various periods of music history. So sit back and enjoy the music. across and said, hey, some traditionally on Monday, Thursday, at or about the time of the washing of the feet, typical to Roman Catholic services, because it's done in Latin here, written by a 20th century French composer who died just 15, 16 years ago, where he's probably an organist, Parisian organist. We're going to follow that with an Easter Sunday morning anthem written by William Billings of Massachusetts, very much written in the Puritan Protestant world of late 18th century composition in the United States. I hope you enjoy the contrast between these two pieces. acoustics. So thank you for leaving the wooden floor up here in the choir and not throwing a lot of carpet down the floor. I'm not speaking for the whole group, I'm just speaking for myself. But we appreciate having this sort of natural floor to rehearse up here. And Reverend Mead, Fred Mead, has been particularly nice in helping us stay organized and not complaining too much when we left chairs a little bit out of place. And I've got this fascinating peppermint jar, not quite in the right place up here in the middle of the choir. It's also time to make an announcement, I suppose, and this one may be of greater significance to us than it is of significance to you, but due to circumstances more or less beyond our control, this is the last performance of the group called La Renaissance, with the exception of a wedding we have to see in a couple of weeks. The last performance of the group called La Renaissance. It is not, however, the last performance of this particular collection of singers. We have named in ourselves after some considerable effort trying to do what's right and proper by all the material that we be singing, and have finally settled on a name which we rather like, in part because it's a subtle reference to the city of Orleans, if you really know the street names. And it's a reference to music, if you really know the subtleties of music history, but we just sort of like it because it's kind of catchy. Turns out one of the nine Greek and Roman muses, those muses who could out-sing the sirens and who put them to shame, one of them, Polynia, eventually came to be associated with hymns of a sacred nature, hymns and poems of a sacred nature. So henceforward, we are going to collect ourselves.